Hello, my name is Devin with HDPiano.com, and in today's lesson, I'll be showing you guys how to play Trampoline by Shade. It's a really cool new tune that doesn't actually feature any piano on the recording, but it translates nicely to the piano so long as you're careful with your pedaling. So we'll talk about that in a bit. We're going to work through the first verse, that's the melody and main riff, and it sounds something like this. One, two. And we're into the chorus. So it's really cool and it's actually quite challenging. So before we break all that stuff down, we're gonna get through that much here in this lesson and then of course the rest of the song over at hdpiano.com. I got a couple questions for you. Two questions. First is, how did you discover Shade? I actually first heard about them a while back because I live in Brooklyn and that's where they got their start. And I was like, wow, this band's doing some cool stuff. And then next thing you know, they've dropped this song, which was just awesome. The first time I heard it, I was like, wow. Then it's in an Apple commercial, then it gets re-released by Zane. So where along their career path did you discover Shade? I know they did some touring with X Ambassadors as well. My second question is a little more fun. Did you have a trampoline as a kid? Because I did, and I gotta say, it was the source of so much joy in my childhood. I feel like they're not as common these days, but comment below if you know about that trampoline life. Okay, here we go. We're in the key of G minor. So that's the relative minor of B flat major. So we're gonna see B flats and E flats throughout, occasional F sharps, but otherwise mostly white notes. So this first chord is G's in the left, D, G, and B flat. G minor. Now, first things first, I just wanna show you how this main riff is working. So we're not gonna worry about the melody to start. We're gonna slow things down and we're gonna talk about triplets. It's very rooted in the triplet rhythm. So we have four beats, one, two, three, four. We're going to divide each of those beats into triplets. So one, two, three, two, two, three, three, two, three, four, two, three. All right, so triplet, 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 triplet. That gives us this swing feel. So eighth notes become dun, 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 dun. I've been having dreams. Dun, 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 trampoline. Dun, 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 dun. Right, you feel that lilt. So understanding that feel is key to really executing this song. So the main riff that we hear in the synth part is totally based in that triplet pattern. And we see this, we see the chord on beat one and then the riff continues on beat two. So one, two, three, and a four, and a one, and a two, and a three, and a four, and a chord. Two, and a, oh, whoops, chord. Two, and a three, and a four, and a one, and a two, and a three, and a four, and a. So it's driven by just the three notes of the chord, the three notes of that G minor triad, D, G, and B flat. And it's one, two, and a three, and a four, and a one, and a two, and a three, and a four, and a. So it's a two beat pattern, and it skips the downbeat. One, a one, and a two, and a three, and a four, and a. All right? So top, middle, top, bottom, middle, bottom, top, bottom, middle, bottom. All right, so that works over G minor. So one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Next chord is B flat major. B flat, F, and B flat in the left. D, F, and B flat. By the way, middle C is here, so we're very low on the keyboard for this song. So one, two, and a three, and a four, and a one, and a two, and a three, and a four, and a. Same exact pattern, but just with these three notes. So instead of G, we have F. Then we go to F major, the chord, and we apply the same pattern to C, F, and A. So one, and a two, and a three, and a four, and a one, and a two, and a three, and a four, and a. And then we have C minor. We have C and G in the left with root position in the right, C, E flat, G. And again, same pattern. Two and a three and a four and a one and a two and a three and a four and a one. So So see if you can play that main riff with me nice and slow. Once we add the melody, we will have to cut out little bits and pieces of it, but for the most part, we're going to carry on with that throughout this first verse. Though later on, it does actually become simpler. The remaining verses are simplified with more just half notes and melody. So, here we go. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and again and a 2 and a 3 4 and a B flat and 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 4 to F and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 to C minor and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1. And that, my friends, is our loop for the verses. Ooh, I don't know. I thought I could maybe whistle while playing. I'm going to give up on that right now. That is going to be hard. Anyways, if you practice enough, you could probably get it, and you could whistle while playing that, which is pretty cool. I love that this song features the whistle in such a really cool way later on. Okay, so we've got the main riff. Practice with that. Loop it nice and slow. Now, I talked about pedaling at the beginning. You might have noticed that for that stuff, I was just holding the pedal down because, you know, we're just playing this chord, and all these notes, they work very well with each other. So if you're holding the pedal down, it doesn't get too muddy. But if you start to incorporate the melody, it just adds a little bit too much. And so we have to start being more careful with the pedal. So what I do is I kind of pedal that first chord, and I quickly let it off, but I try and be lazy with my right hand. Not maybe lazy is the wrong word, but holding down the notes as I go. So it almost sounds like I'm still sustaining these notes, but I let that lower note ring out, because in the recording it's just like this low boom, like synth stab, and then there's a ton of reverb, so it just trails off. So if your keyboard has reverb, this would be a song to turn up the reverb on. So boom, down. All right, let's look at that melody. So it's all in this kind of G minor, mostly 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, G, A, B flat, C, D, and we'll have the occasional F in there as well. And I guess we do have some E flats as well. So it's just straight up G natural minor. It's the B flat major scale starting on G. Okay. So the melody is D, C, B flat, C, D. And we hit this G minor root position chord, and then we resume the main riff until we repeat that. And for that, we fill in the chord below with F and B flat. That gives us B flat major. Gotta leave your pinky open to hit that F. And then, same melody there, starting on B flat. D, C, B flat, C, and then landing on F major root position. F, A, C. And then, So we take that C up to D and back down. So 3 and a 4 and 1, 2. That's C minor, E flat, G, C, landing on G. So I've been having dreams. 2, 3. And release. All right, kind of simulate that pop, sudden break there. So all that's left is to incorporate that main riff. Let's take it even slower and see if you can slowly work your way up to tempo. So 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 1, 2, 3. 4, 1, 2, melody. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, and off, and again. Flat, 3. Now here it's a little different. We start with F and B flat, and the melody is E flat walking down to A. So we land here on F and A, and we do it again with F and A below. And then we just do E flat D, but from B flat. Walking down to A and walking down again and just D and then C and E flat, and I've got this nice meaty power chord on the left, C, G, C. C, E flat with the melody on F up to G, adding B flat and then dropping C and adding D on top. Right beside. And then we just kind of wash into this E-flat 6 chord. So we'll get to that in the next video. I'm just going to play through this super slow one more time. Hope you can play along and slowly work your way up to tempo. I definitely recommend a metronome for this one because you really want to get those triplet subdivisions right on point. You could even set your metronome to do and just really make sure you're locked in metronomically. So here we go from the top. One. And a 2, and a 3, and a 4, and a 1, and a 2, and a 3, and a 4, and a 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, and a 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, and again. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, alright, it's up to you if you want to hold the pedal for those last chords. Or do some clean breaks. You could even try catching the pedal just as you let off, something like, let's see. It's hard to simulate on a keyboard, but on a real piano, if you right as you let off, if you hold the pedal, you can see the pedal in the gray background of the video. You can maybe just catch a little bit of harmonics. It's kind of a cool effect. Anyways, I'm going to leave you with that. That's a slow playthrough of Trampoline. Great work. It actually gets a lot easier from here, but now you know the main riff and you know the melody. So we'll see you over at hdpiano.com to learn the chorus. My name is Devin. And while you're here, please like and subscribe and follow us across social media. We'll see you in a bit.